Choir, thank you. And thank you, parents, for providing the wheels. Someday soon, you'll have to pay more insurance. Maybe you do already. I don't know. In this season where we look back to the first coming, to the first advent, we have the opportunity to focus on four words. This week's word is hope. It's a nice name. Several parents have decided to name their daughters Hope. I don't know of any gentlemen who've been named Hope. However, when the children are small, there are many hopes and dreams that are associated with them, and so I think that it is very appropriate that we have the word hope. So we invite us all in this season to join in with this focal exercise. That's not vocal exercise, it's a focal exercise. Okay, just the choir knows about vocal exercises. It will strengthen, I believe, our resolve to keep Christ, the Messiah, same word, different languages, in focus in all parts of our lives. And I want to thank Mr. Jason Hinkle, brother of Jared Hinkle, for his excellent sleight of hand this morning, because it helps us to focus on the reason for the season. So today we concentrate on the word hope. 'Twas the night before Christmas and all through the house. Are you going to finish it for me? Not a creature was stirring, not even the mouse. Now, the mouse was a newcomer to town, to that particular house. In fact, he and his wife had been hunted furiously in Queens, New York. Sorry if you're from Queens. Sorry, I just had to choose somewhere where there are mice on the East Coast. So they hopped an 18-wheeler and crossed the USA and ended up in, of all places, Santa Clarita, California. Now, mice don't need much to set up house, but Mrs. Mouse had said, "It must be warm and dry. I have a litter on the way, you know." And Mr. Mouse had listened. He had scurried about in Saugus. Nothing. He scooted around in Canyon Country and couldn't find room. He scoured Valencia and found it too rich for his blood. Finally, he heard tell of Happy Valley in Newhall. Upon first look, no sidewalks. Nice. Big trees. Great. And what was that? Oh, he saw a sign that said, "A little patch of earth." And then this other sign right next to it that said, "The Advent Church." This was it. And he and Mrs. Mouse moved into the acreage. Soon the little ones came, and the crowds of little kids that left their crumbs also helped the mice family to enlarge. That was, of course, the scraps from the potlucks that happened there as well, filling their little mouse bellies. So you see, not even the mouse family was stirring that night before Christmas. Mrs. Mouse was high in an oak, Mr. Mouse, excuse me, was high in an oak tree stargazing. So many of his hopes and dreams had already been realized. You see, such a long journey from Queens. His family was flourishing out here in Santa Clarita. He hoped his family back in Queens was well. He hadn't seen much of them on Mousebook lately. All he could do was hope. Mr. Mouse reminds us all that in this world where dark focuses seem to delight in stealing our souls, there is a light. There is a light that shines in the darkness. This light is talked about right there in the very first verses of the Gospel of John. Came into this world and was the light that was to shine should we lose our way as humans. That light came into the world in the beginning and created life as we know it on this planet. That light chose a family in humanity to show us the way to live. It was into that family, of course, that Jesus was born. That light gave hope to a slave people in Egypt and led them into the desert. There the light lit the night and shaded the day. That pillar of light protected them from the pursuing Egyptians. Then the light rested on the meeting tent, showing willingness to dwell with his people in a tent, just like them. Years later, that light came into the world and took on human form, 100% God, 100% man at the same time. Because like people of old, we live in a land darkened by rebellion, we need hope. We need hope. There's this light that brings hope. Hope for a brighter tomorrow. Hope for a fresh start. Hope for more energy. Parents, I didn't hear an amen, but that's okay. Hope for a better relationship with your family and your loved ones. Hope for a cure for disease. Hope for special Christmas presents this year, 2017. You see, hope springs eternal, the saying goes. Hope comes from the eternal. It is a gift of God, and we celebrate that gift at this time of the year. You see, that light makes it possible for us to have light at the end of the tunnel. Sometimes in these days, it seems as if the darkness is closing in like a tunnel. But there is a light that shines. And because that light shines, there is hope. And because we have hope, we can go on. Light brings hope. Hope brings peace, joy, and love. So it's fitting, of course, that at the beginning of this Advent season, we look at the word hope. Maybe in the songs that are sung today, maybe in the actions of your loved ones, you will see and feel and hear hope. I hope so. All gifts from the one who started it all long, long ago, I say to us, very carefully, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and there was nothing that was made without Him. He was there at the beginning. He knew that if we got to this point in human history and we needed rescuing, that rescue measures would be deployed. and that he would be the Savior, the Messiah, the coming one. It's why Eve named her firstborn Cain. Cain means I have acquired. Isn't that what we all want to do at Christmas time? Acquire that which our hearts desire. She thought that he would be the one. Then came Abel, which means vapor. It has nothing to do with all the vape shops. However, his life was just as fleeting as a puff of smoke from an overdone Acura. Then came Seth, and so today I will leave you with this little riddle. All of our Cain is Abel, and our only hope is Seth. All of our Cain is Abel, and our only hope is Seth. Cain killed Abel, and Seth came as a replacement. And as such, the line of Christ from Adam comes through Seth and not Cain, telling us of the grace and mercy of God in the very first three children of this world. That though you think that you can acquire salvation yourself, the end of that kind of life will be like a vapor for which there is no posterity. Your only hope is the replacement child, known as Seth in the story of Adam and Eve. So as we contemplate the first advent, the first coming, let us remember our only hope is the child, the one that Eve was told would come, but she died, what, 900 years later? But she is dead. She is gone. She died wishing that he would come to save her and her family so that they could go back to where they had come from, their original home. My friends, as we celebrate the first Advent, let us also grab fully our heritage as the Advent people. Let us make sure that we know that because of the first Advent, we have hope today. We call ourselves Adventists. Please grab fully into the meaning of that and know that we are here today because there has been a commission given that there should be a people who will tell the world that there is a man who has come to save us, and that he is going to break into human history again, this time not as a baby, this time as a conquering king riding with his angels. But my grandfather used to say, would be like paratroopers from heaven to deliver us. So, unlike Mr. Mouse on Christmas Eve, let's not get too comfortable, shall we? Let's remember that there was violence and there was anger and there was slavery when Jesus came the first time, and he said that when I come again, it will be like that. If you look at the world today and you get all comfy, beware that maybe this poem about the sleepiness of all those in the house needs not to be about us, but maybe needs to be about others. If Jesus is about to come, my friends, we need to be ready. We need to be awake. We need to be able to tell others, this is what it is like. This is what it is like when the Son of Man will come again. Be ready for the Advent. Be ready to give hope to those who have lost hope. Hope to those who have lost the light at the end of the tunnel. So many of them are grasping at what is offered today in our world and finding that they come up empty every time. Grasp, my friends, grasp the hand of the man who stilled the waters, the hand of the man who walked this world. Grasp that hand again today and say, come, Lord Jesus, come soon. Amen. Amen.